Facebook is deleting over 1 billion users' facial recognition records. An Android bug is being actively exploited, so update right now. And the US is offering a huge reward to anyone who outs dark side ransomware leaders. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse, and this is ThreatWire for November 9, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. A big thank you to Michael for joining this week on Patreon, patreon.com/threatwire, as always, to keep the show ad-free. And if you want to support the show, but you don't want to join on Patreon, you can grab your own ThreatWire merchandise, like this awesome t-shirt, for the holidays at the link below. I do have a public shop, so you can check out all sorts of different swag. And with that, on to the news. On November 2nd, Facebook announced via their news blog that they are shutting down their facial recognition system on the Facebook platform. Facebook, who recently rebranded to the name Meta, is making this company-wide transition to limiting the use of facial recognition in their products, and as such, they're also shutting down the face recognition system. So that means if you are a user who opted into the face recognition setting, that feature will no longer automatically recognize faces in photos and videos, and the template used to identify faces will be deleted. According to Facebook's post, more than a third of active daily users have this option, which was introduced in the early days of the platform, turned on so their faces are recognized in uploaded media. The deletion of the system will result in more than a billion people's individual facial recognition templates being removed. That's a lot of people. Facebook for years has offered the ability to be notified if you appear in photos or videos that are uploaded by other parties or recommendations who want to tag you in photos. Those features will be shut down as well, since they were powered by the face recognition system. Now, Facebook, or Meta, considers facial recognition to be a valuable tool, stating that it is used to help people on their platform who are visually impaired know whenever they are in a photo, for example. They also state that it can be used to verify identities or to prevent fraud or impersonation, and how facial recognition can be used to locally unlock a device. While shutting down this main system, they still plan to work on these kinds of technologies as well. Since there are not clear standards in society or regulations around its use yet, Facebook has decided that it was time to remove this one. Now, this is a positive move to me, especially since family and friends may have turned this setting on and not thought about the data storage or repercussions, or potentially just forgot that that setting even existed. Google has patched a good 18 vulnerabilities in the framework and system components, and another 18 in kernel and vendor components in their November of 2021 security patch for Android. So, TLDR, update. It's a lot, so I won't cover everything here, but you can view the entire security bulletin on the Android source blog. Most of the CVEs patched in this update are deemed high severity, with a few being critical. Most of them include vulnerabilities listed as elevation of privilege or remote code execution attacks. There's also a few listed as information disclosure or denial of service attacks as well, all of which are pretty big concerns whenever they are used in the wild. The most severe of these problems is found in the system components. These would allow an attacker to use specially crafted transmissions to execute arbitrary code for privileged processes. These are listed as CVE-2021-0918 and CVE-2021-0930, and they affect Android operating systems back to version 9. The kernel is also affected by a use after free problem that could allow an attacker to gain escalated privileges on this component. This one is CVE-2021-1048. Now, Google states in their post that there are indications this last one may be under limited and targeted exploitation. Users of Android devices should look under their settings for an update if you have not received any kind of notification. This patch is rolling out and the updates will include the November framework. There's the vendor and kernel patches. There's also the October framework, vendor and kernel patches as well, if not already installed. These are notable as it's the first security patch for the new Android 12, but it also includes some patches for Android 9, 10, and 11. The Pixel 3 will not receive this patch as it has reached its end of its support cycle, which is so sad, but if you are considering updating, I did just post a review of the Pixel 6 Pro with a Pixel 6 review upcoming on my channel as well. Both of these phones have 5 years of updates from Google, so definitely take it into consideration. I love it when y'all send me these adorable pictures of your pets. So these are a few from my Hush Puppy Patreon Alliance members, and I did want to say, rest in peace, Keela. We will miss you. You can always support this content and keep it ad-free for as little as $2 per month, and you can get a slew of perks at the same time. Each and every single Alliance member gets over 10 different perks as soon as you sign up at patreon.com/threatwire. And with that, onto the third news story. So the US government is tired of DarkSide's shenanigans, so they are offering a $10 million reward for information that leads to IDing or arresting members of the ransomware gang. This news comes from the US Department of State, which focuses on leadership in DarkSide and any of its rebranded groups as well. They are also offering a $5 million reward for information that leads to an arrest of individuals participating in DarkSide attacks in any country. Now, since the US government post also includes DarkSide variant ransomware, that includes Black Matter as well. Remember them? That's the ransomware that hit the Colonial Pipeline earlier this year. Unsurprisingly, Black Matter also announced they were shutting down operations due to them feeling, quote, pressure from the authorities, and after some members have disappeared. This ransomware as a service group posted on November 1st that they were shutting down in 48 hours, but the group is still extorting victims by transitioning them to Lockbit's negotiation site. So it appears that Black Matter and Lockbit are kind of collabing to continue ransoming these targeted victims. The US Department of State's Transnational Organized Crime Rewards Program has paid out over $135 million in rewards to date. This week, I am reviewing some smart home goodies. Don't worry, I put them on a separate IoT network. It's all good. You can check that out over at youtube.com/Shannon Morse. Check out my channel for that video, and don't forget to like and subscribe as well. And like and subscribe to this channel. At this time of recording, which is Monday, we are about 100 subscribers away from 750,000. That is insane to me. I'm so excited about that. I'm probably going to have a beer or something. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.